Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Computer Wednesday. Today we're going to take a look at UPS. So what does this thing means? It's basically uninterruptible power supply. What does that allow is very simple thing. It's imagine this way, your computer is running on mains power. What happens if your main power fails? UPS is there to act on that and allows you safety net to shut down your computer safely. That's all it does. And it uses battery for its main power supply, and it's generally meant for short duration, like 5 to 10 minutes. 1 to 2 hours is also possible, but it's generally meant for short-term duration. So why do we need things like that? Well, one, you have to understand the core reason why we even bother with that is with data integrity. Basically, imagine if you're writing a file in your hard drive and then power cut happens, that data is not only that, your whole file can be corrupted. This is especially painful if you are dealing with anything that is sensitive or critical, or worst case scenario, let's say you're doing a video editing and while you are doing the editing or, you know, rendering it, it crashes. It can corrupt the whole file regarding that. So for data integrity, it's quite essential. And it also allows for hardware safety, because when you shut down properly, all the capacitors and the things that are in your motherboard and everything related to it, they shut down safely. It's not that you cut the connection, it's unsafe because some capacitor may still hold charge. So for safety reasons, you want to make sure your hardware is safe. And then you have to understand the grid, no matter where you live, whichever country you live in, the grid is not 100%. Sometimes it has low voltage, sometimes it has high voltage, sometimes it could have spikes. For this sort of reason, grid is not, you know, 100% of the time. So for this reason, UPS becomes a quite integral part. So even if you have a very good electricity situation, you still want to have a small UPS just in case, you know. So UPS are generally divided in two categories for understanding purpose. Think of it this way, it has power and it has capacity. These two do not intermingle. So you can have a UPS that has very low power but have very high capacity. You can have vice versa, or you can have something that is very high capacity and very high power. So let's dig a bit into it. So most of you must be familiar with the UPS rating is like VA. Do not worry about it. It's VA or watt. It simply means how much it can handle. So let's say your UPS says 500 watt. That means it can handle 500 watt load. So the reason why we hear VA so much is basically is the same reason why music industry uses PMP or peak music power output rather than RMS. It's a bigger number, so it sells and it's mathematically correct. However, it is generally 30% less of what your UPS can actually do. So let's say you buy a UPS that can do 800 VA, that means roughly 500 watts of capacity. This is a deal with because of transformers. Depending on load, the output can vary. That's why they give you VA, which is optimistic. So, and because if you say watt, people can easily measure it. So generally, it's a safe idea to assume whatever your capacity is, VA wise, you're gonna be 30% below that in terms of watt. Then we come down to the battery part. Now, battery is generally rated at two factors, voltage and amps. Now, voltage is generally standardized, is generally 12 volts, so we don't have to worry about it. However, amp hour is the main reason. Now, amp hour is like, it will tell you how long, basically how big your tank is of electricity. So to figuring out how much you know, juice you actually have, you have to do amp hour into volts. So let's say you have generally this 12 volt into 9 amps, multiply that and you will get the 70 watt capacity roughly for this battery. And let's say your UPS has 2, that means 70 into 2, so you have capacity of 140 watts. Now let's say your computer consumes 100 watts, let's say it's a laptop, let's say it consumes 100 watts, and then you can easily calculate you're gonna run more than 1 hour. So this is how you calculate the capacity, how long it's gonna run. So let's do a quick summary. Power is measured by VA, go 30% below that, that's your watt capacity. Battery, multiply the amp hour to voltage and do it on a battery level, because some UPS have dual battery but have same voltage. Some have serial batteries which increase the voltage. So that's why generally it's a good idea to do it at battery level. So just count how many batteries you have. So let's say some can have 2, 3, 4. So that was the aspect of power and capacity. Now we come down to the types. So let's start with the biggest and the bulkiest is online UPS. Like this, they are generally very popular with very serious application, office loads or ATMs or wherever you don't want to take a risk, especially medical industry relies on this. And they are, suffice to say, they are almost meant to run 24/7/365. So they are very big, they are very bulky, they are very expensive, and battery voltage on these, rather than 12 volt, they can go as high as 200 volts. So like, don't be surprised, like these puppies are not meant to be taken lightly. And the reason why people even buy these is very simple. It directly allows your computer to run on batteries all the time. So you'll be like, okay, how the heck is charging? That is the trick of online UPS. There is a AC power that comes in, convert it to DC, then charges the battery. Battery goes to the DC to AC, and then you have the AC power running your equipment. The reason for that is called galvanic isolation. Basically, no matter what happens to your mains, basically it has could have very large fluctuation, it wouldn't care. It you could have like power cut down, it wouldn't care. You could have like spikes coming in, it wouldn't care. Heck, you can have lightning drop on it and it can safely shut it down. So of course it will be destroyed in the process, but it will keep your equipment safe. So online UPS is the, you know, that's the best we can get if you have the money for it and place to keep it. Then we come to UPS inverter. This is quite popular nowadays, specifically in a place where you can expect to have long power outages, like where I am. I'm gonna buy a big UPS quite quickly. And I would advise you to, if you are buying something like this, please make sure you buy sine wave. They are meant to run for hours. So you're gonna run your computer for, let's say, 1 hour or 2 hours. It's advised to run it on sine wave. High-end power supply flat out will shut down the power if they detect square wave. So please buy sine wave if you are going to run it for long. And then we come to the cheapest one, which we call line interactive UPS. All it does is has a stabilizer built into it. So if you have over voltage, it will control it. If you have under voltage, it will boost it up. And these are, if you have very good light connection, like, you know, you don't have voltage drop, you don't have voltage spike, this will do you fine. If you have, like, you know, your power is good, but, you know, the blackouts can be for 2-3 hours, you're gonna buy this. And if you are running very critical operation, no matter the quality of power, you're still gonna employ this. So this was my presentation. I hope you guys liked it or learned from it. In that case, please like. And if you didn't, dislike, leave a comment, subscribe, and press the bell icon. I make video every day. Thanks for watching.